York Times and a Wall Street Journal story, but before we do, we're going to tie us all back in. I'm Tom McKay, your host, 3D Politics. David Vann, yeah. David Oldham, and David D'Ambroso, the most important Davids in Oklahoma, all things political, all things important. Tell us about the Russian probe, just upgraded to criminal investigation. This is your story.
Yeah, they actually sent that up in the atmosphere like 70 or 80 years ago. I think it was called Sputnik.
Oh, wow. I was against it.
We're way behind them on these probes. But no, I mean, Trump's just turning around on it. I mean, it got upgraded to a criminal investigation. They're dotting their I's and crossing their T's. And it is just amazing. You can't listen to it. We're very empathetic people as conservatives. And the left, they are like a petulant child.
Yes.
They will throw rocks at your face all day, break your bones, steal your things, attempt to kill you. And as soon as you say, how about you quit it, they start screaming, why are you oppressing me? Why are you persecuting my kid? Why is it a far right-wing conspiracy that I've committed all these felonies and now I'm being held accountable? Them ain't the rules. I meant the rules, and you have to agree to them. And the rules are, I win all the time, I'm right, I get everything, you get nothing. And the reason why Trump is so dangerous to the establishment of both parties, and I'll just leave this here, open it up for comment, is because he is just turning the rules upside down. The rules that the establishment Republicans, even in this state and around the country, have been playing by for years and years, the Mitt Romney-style politics, they've signed up for, we lose, Democrats win. And they've agreed to those rules, and they don't like it now that Trump has disinvited the movement from this agreement.
Yeah, your description was right on. A liberal progressive is like a 3 to 5 year old petulant child. So it's like, give me candy. Okay, here's some candy. It's not enough candy. Okay, here's some more candy. It's not the candy I like.
The amount of candy you ask for is, you know, six times the amount of candy that exists. Well, I don't care. I want it.
It never ends.
Okay, I'll get it.
It never ends with the progressives. They're liars by innate characteristics.
We've been sold. I'll say for the guys on each side of me here, we've been sold this generational, this several decades long sense of shame. In the 60s, we were white, so we had to feel shame because of racism. In the 70s, we had to feel ashamed because women didn't have equal rights, you know? And then it just goes on and on, the 80s, 90s, in this just intense effort to make us feel like we have to apologize has really captured much of our society, except Donald Trump. He doesn't feel ashamed of anything.
Well, and people like us, because I don't think we've bought, or that we have fully bought into it, or we are coming out of it.
Yeah.
I know that I've had to work my way out of it,
yeah.
But remember that the media has been trying to sell us our Stockholm syndrome.
Mm.
It's all part of, and I hate the word brainwashing because it's really brain muddying.
Well, academia has been doing it too, and the established bureaucrats. You got to think of the
deep
state.
Yes. Oh, of course. And it's tyrants in general. It's not just the left. It's tyrants and tyranny in
general. But it's mostly
general.
The left.
Yes, of course, it's mostly the left.
Yeah, come on.
They are by definition tyrants. Just look at their names. Stop and think about it, folks. Democrat means mob rule. That's what it means. That's what they stand for. That's the name of their party, the mob rule party. Because because if everything that we do, everything, and they want to put everything to a vote.
Yes.
Okay. Right. They want to put your rights to a vote.
That means
mob rule and pure lawlessness. Now that's the Democrats.
From a point of criminality. Their ideology is criminal.
Yes, and we need to start recognizing that and acknowledging that. But we have people calling themselves right wing, and they are tyrants, and they are doing the same thing.
It does, and it happens. The moralists on the right will do it.
Yes.
Yeah, from a religious point of view and other things, we're going to be talking about Mayor Bynum here in Tulsa a little bit later tonight. Mr. Shame, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. You let your kids do that, you know. But a lot of times that shaming becomes a tool by which they can then tax you.
Correct.
It's basically what they call sin tax.
Right.
That means we've shamed your behavior. Now we would get to tax it even higher.
And that's criminal, folks. That's nothing more than the same old, same old. Selling you on your guilt and then doing something to punish you for it. Yeah. And that is criminal.
Because, and like 90% of the neo-Puritans are on the left. I call them neo-Puritans. They're on the left. And you have to say, we must never apologize for being right. And we were asked to apologize, like that weak, disgusting man Mitt Romney, which we should give him the McCain treatment, which I already broke it, and maybe not even say his name anymore. But he apologized for being right in a presidential debate. That might have cost him. Might have cost the country, because it wasn't about him. It was about what he represented. Now, he wouldn't have been nearly as strong of a leader as Trump, but he would have turned the economy back on. Right. He would have rolled back some regulations and things like that.
Maybe got health care. Avoiding Obamacare because it hadn't been implemented by
although he did create Romneycare, which was the basis in the state.
Yeah, that's true.
Who knows?
It was headed that direction, and Romney wasn't going to...
But shaming, too. But, you know, we've got to consider this and have a real conversation about it. I don't know what the answer is, but we may need to adopt some of the tactics of the left. I'm not talking about lying or being immoral or abandoning our principles in any way. But maybe we need to shame people and say, well, maybe it's a shame that you've got 8 kids and the government pays for them. Maybe it's a shame you don't know who their parents are. Maybe it's a shame that you're stealing my money. Maybe it's a shame that you are a degenerate and you're involved in all these deviancies and you want me to pay for it. Maybe that's a shame.
Excellent. Didn't I say that a couple months ago?
You've been saying that a lot.
That is not a tactic of the left. I mean, there's a thing called, apparently there's a problem with slut shaming, and my reaction was, if you can't shame a slut, who can you shame? Okay, but the thing is, you invoke the name of the mayor Bynum, and I'll speak to defend him. He is similar to Trump. In that he used his bully pulpit, his spokesman, to set the example for the community. And he, in my opinion, it's not his, Bynum's area to shame, but it is Trump's area to be commander-in-chief and tell us how the dog died in combat. That's a proper role of shaming your enemy in combat.
Right.
It is not
the
proper role of Bynum to use the bully pulpit that is proper to use, but to use it by shaming parents. More, he should slut shame.
Well, the thing is, that he should be shaming the criminal element, not the lawful element.
There you go.
Right now, what he's doing is he's trying to shame lawful people.
Which one are you talking about? Bynum shaming. Yeah,
he's shaming law-abiding people into compliance with an illegal action. He's done it with the OIM. He's done it with...
I was just talking about playing in the stormwater. Which one are you talking about?
I think we've got local issues. Again.
We're drawing it together because it's proper to shame people who need to be shamed.
Yeah, I'm just saying
it's not a tactic of the left, is what I'm saying.
Right, but
they use it mostly.
The attempt to use shame politically on Trump is not working. He is not biting on that apple.
Well, he has nothing to be ashamed of. This is the big thing. If you've got nothing to be ashamed of, don't be ashamed.
I've got to push you back on that a little. I love the president. I think he's the greatest. I'm going to say this. I think he's the greatest president in the history of the country. That being said, he does have things to be ashamed of.
Yeah.
And some of it's on his Twitter feed. Some of it's his past actions. But here's the point. He doesn't have to live there. Okay. I mean, you just point back at the left because they've got... magnitudes more shame, and they want to poke at the speck in his eye and say, well, you're a human being and you are flawed. Well, of course he is.
And let me clarify, I was talking about what they're talking about, what they're trying to shame him on.
Right.
The thing is, they never try to shame him on something that is actually shameful.
But other than shame, and this is close to it, is the media ridicule. And some people are so deathly afraid of media ridicule. I'm going to use example. Rush Limbaugh was talking about it. He said he was playing golf with some fellas down in 2012 down in Florida. And a couple of these guys said, Rush, we've got to get McCain to replace Sarah Palin off the ticket. Man. And he says, why? He says, oh, the media is just having a heyday with her. It's just horrible what's happening. And he says, wait a minute. Are you saying we should let the media pick the running mate?
Yeah, yeah, I heard that line.
You know?
Right.
And then, huh? And he says, because that's really what you're saying. Is you're saying that you're willing to kowtow to the media, let them pick somebody because you don't want to be ridiculed by them. You're afraid of their ridicule. And I'm saying Trump is not afraid of their ridicule.
Correct.
Right. And have you seen that photo of McCain with al-Baghdadi supporting that the moderate rebels?
Oh, Baghdadi was in that picture?
That was Baghdadi to John McCain.
Well, Hillary sold him weapons. McCain was over there brokering them. Obama signed off on the entire
thing.
McCain
was supporting the leader of ISIS. It's unbelievable.
ISIS was literally an American creation. Without America, it didn't happen.
Going back to the Steele dossier just a little bit, the DOJ, just a callback. McCain was one that personally handed off the fake Steele dossier.
Let me tell you this.
Yes.
McCain said, his family said to Trump, don't come to this funeral. If I'm Donald Trump or any of our brave young soldiers who died, I wouldn't go near McCain now, knowing that.
McCain was a great fighter pilot, just not both at the same time.
Disgusting, man.
You know, either fly the plane or fire the missile.
I think he
got
shot down twice. That was the extent of his service.
I don't get one of the worst. I know Marines, they say, you know, once a Marine, always a Marine. Listen, McCain ceased to be who he was in the Hanoi Hilton.
A long time ago. Mark Wayne Mullen and Hearn are absolutely correct. He is disgusting, and we shouldn't even say his name. I'll leave it there. This is not a joke.
I don't even
like to say his name.
Oh, no.
I really don't. But the people who were with him in prison actually would say he never did change because he was like that in prison. So, just like
a reservation.
I hate to talk about it, but I heard that he didn't have to. Now, this is hearsay. Unlike a leftist or an Dallas Republican, I'll tell you that. But I heard that he was not coerced extensively to give up information on American soldiers and positions.
Yeah. The first time I saw Trump ever step in it, he was with Frank Luntz in Iowa. It was a one-on-one forum where Frank is interviewing all of them. And he mentions McCain, and you know, not in a nice way. Trump does. And he says, well, he's an American hero. And Trump turns to Luntz and says, oh, I don't know. I mean, what did he do that was heroic? I mean, he didn't do anything heroic. He just suffered.
He's like, I like my heroes to not get captured.
That's what he said.
And Luntz went, whoa.
Yeah. And I thought he was done. I thought Trump is done.
Yeah, Trump was like, I like our American military heroes to not cause us a lot of casualties on intel losses to the other side.
There you go.
That's just my preference.
We know from the Access Hollywood tape that Trump has grabbed the left by the media.